Welcome back, everyone, to another episode of Train Simulator Pro USA. In this mission, we're actually going to make a nice bit of money just by doing some short missions. So first off, it's the Kenwick Food Factory to Kenwick Train Yard, a local run. Nice, beautiful day on the Western Maryland and Western Pacific Railroad, and I'm going on the wrong track. And to some of your questions about when this game's gonna update, I do not have an answer for you folks. Oh hey, there goes a train full of tools or furniture. I think this episode we're going to be reliving the good old days because of all these, because those two, three missions that we're going to be doing are nothing but local runs. I don't know if that sun's setting or rising. Speaking of local, Here goes MWP 5156. Looks like that loco did drop off some grain hoppers. I don't know why the couplers don't show when they're just sitting there. I'm going to assume that's a bug. Disconnect. That's a long mission, but time for a local run. We're going to use all four of the GP7s. Trip back in time. Looks like we got some grain cars also stored here. I don't know if they're loaded or not. They're probably empty. Now it's time for us to depart Beijing Power Plant. P7s are having a hard time getting up to speed with 20 coal hoppers behind them. It looks like we have to come to a stop at the next signal for a passenger train, probably. For those of you who don't know what the inside of the EP7 looks like, this is what it looks like, and I'm actually going to creep up a little bit to where I can see the signal. And I was right. Go track P54. It's right in front of us. I wonder if the future update will upgrade these signals into the Darth Vader signals that people have been calling the mainline signals, since they look like Darth Vader instead of these old ones that FEC, that the Florida East Coast Railway has, or had. Not gonna lie, they do their job pretty good, but I think something more modern will probably suit us better on the Maryland and Western Pacific Railroad. But who knows? Well, let's get on this journey to Vancouver. The reason why I don't have headlights on is because we only recommend putting headlights on when it's night or when it's raining. When it's both night and raining, then we're required to put our bright headlights on. And one thing about the Maryland and Western Pacific River is that we are always on time and on schedule. The only thing that can set us back a little bit is when we're building the trains, but we easily make up for the lost time. this Coltrane identity is C505. And overshoot. Technically still a stoplight, even though it says 55 and we overshot. The loaded sugar train bound for Portland. Since it's clear of the switch, we are departing. In this area of the Maryland and Western Pacific Railroad, you will always, always find switching action happen here. Because you got the food factory right there, you got the chemical factory right there, you got the train station right here, and just a little ways down this track is the train yard. So there's always action here. Actually, let me finish this local mission, and then we got a long train that we can haul to Vancouver. But where are the passenger missions, like, out of curiosity? Useless as per always. And, again, also useless. We could travel Acetone. I don't know though. But anyways, We're going to test out the F7 units on this one. Hopefully, it's fixed. We were able to fix the issue with the wheels disappearing. And if not, I think we're probably going to have to never use the F7 units until they get repaired. So far, so good. Okay, so they did disappear on the B unit, so that means we're probably never going to see 57 and 71 ever in action until it gets fixed. Because I don't want to risk a derailment happening. There goes P607. It's actually been quite a while since we ever visit Aberdeen at all. here in Aberdeen Train Yard, just want to make sure I got the name right, is one of the couple of ports that we have on the Washington and Maryland Railroad, where things get loaded up by ship, or loaded up into containers, and loaded up onto a ship. Like we might have derailed a bit. Let me check. Okay, no, it's just the way how the shadow was. Let's actually do this Acetone mission just to get it out of the way. Because then I could get a gem. So we're going to be using the X Maryland Southern units and two RC-44s. Even then, that probably won't be enough. Well, I got the money, so I might as well just keep spending it until I get it all. Cars, tankers. I'm going to buy a lot of these. What else could I buy? I'm going to buy another coil car. I'm going to buy another wire car. And for the sake of it, I'm going to buy another metal car. And I'll just buy, get up to 20. Alright, so we don't need the other RC-44, and the E-830 units, they're going to be leading their own hell train from a Tacoma all the way to Wauhatchia. The inside of these southern. Aren't I not getting a cab? I think it might be bugged. Let me couple up to these tanker cars slowly, because these are chemicals. Oh, here it is. I just had to refresh it. This is what the inside of the PC-44 looks like. As you can tell, this is 8135, even though it says different on the outside. I'm debating on something. Should I let this train go through the devil's curve to get to where it needs to go? I mean, we had that tragedy with the passenger train. Or lost its brakes. And crashed. Only thing difference with this train is that it's carrying chemicals. Thank you. of training. So it's probably a good idea that I didn't haul that wood train, because then all that wood would have been ruined. I'm informing the crew to let them know to put tarps over the wood train when it gets ready for the next episode, which will be out tomorrow. Episode 3. Of season 6. Seeing all these tanker cars on the train is kind of creepy. Cause it's like a rolling bomb, almost. It's actually good that we got the rain, because the last few times I've played this, there's been like no rain, and that's been like 5 days in a row, which is kind of uncommon for this game. So I'm glad the rain's back. Although, since it's December, and for the winter season, I would kind of like to see it snowing. You know, and there'd be snow on the ground. That'd be a nice little touch to the game. But since we're having like 50 degree weather and nothing but thunderstorms where I live, kind of makes sense to me. Anyways, gotta blow my horn for this crossing. It's a private crossing, that's why there's like no lights or gates on it. Oh well. Time to rev up the engine. Got a local passenger train that's going to stop at the Beijing station right there. And we got a tanker train filled with diesel fuel for the Beijing power plant. left is about 3 minutes early. But what's that passenger train going to stop at that station for a little bit? For about 2 minutes. This wind turned on never used. It must be broken. Or there might not just be no wind. Who knows? I tried to muffle myself with that cough coming. Alright, there's the sun, so it's going to be setting. I'm hoping we arrive at Bend Chemical. Wait, where are we going? Bend Chemical Factory. We still got a little ways to go, probably like 30 miles, 40 miles, something like that. So we might arrive there at the evening hours. Sunflower farm. You're right. Wow, that's a lot of sunflowers, actually. Holy crap. Actually, my arrival there after evening now is going to keep this up. Not that far away. We actually might arrive before the evening hours, which would still be good. We're arriving at the Bend Chemical Factory. Everyone, I hope you enjoyed episode 2 of season 6 on Train Simulator Pro USA. I hope you all had a good Christmas, and the new year is coming up. I might do a live stream event on that, depending on the weather. But I don't know yet. Once again, it was another very successful day on the Maryland and Western Pacific Railroad. Be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you all in episode 3. Have a nice night.